Yeah. Hey, Brian. I just talked to you. Hey, Kelly. How you doing?
I got 3 weeks.
I know. It's gonna be that
white.
Here's your side.
Everybody, we want to welcome you to the Manger Tales Christmas program here at Evergreen Christian Church. We are very excited to have you here this evening, and we hope you enjoy the show. We ask that whenever we sing our Christmas songs, you are invited to join along with us. And the kids have been working really hard, and I know they're going to do a great job. So without further ado, we're going to present to you the Manger Tales Christmas program.
Good evening. I'm Lindy Lou, and today on Lindy Lou Live, we're beginning a four-part series on the story of Christmas. We've all read the stories from the Gospels of Luke and Matthew, how the baby Jesus was born, but we've never really heard the stories from the people who were actually there. I try to get a hold of these people to tell their stories, but none of them would talk to me. I think it's my bad breath. Anyway, I decided that I would have to get the next best thing. So today, we're going to be meeting the animals from the Christmas story, starting with my guest today, Doug the Donkey. Doug, welcome to Lindy Lou Live.
Thanks, Lindy.
It's Lindy.
It is.
Doug, do you remember meeting the baby Jesus?
Oh, what a cutie. He was a cutie, Lindy. He had the cutest little dimple.
You saw the baby Jesus?
Saw him here in North Bethlehem.
Wait, I thought he was born in Bethlehem.
He was. But who do you think heard his mother drag the child all the way across the desert?
Was it you?
Well, it sure was a jackrabbit.
I didn't think it was.
Can't imagine a jackrabbit carrying pregnant lady.
Neither can I.
It should say, "Mind if I have one?" It's a "Mind if I have boys?"
Okay, so when did you know that this baby Jesus was someone special?
I knew Jesus was special before he was even born.
How?
Because of his mother and father. They wouldn't stop talking about him. Now I knew most parents are like that, even if the kid is a total goober.
Tell me about it.
But not all parents find that their child is from an angel. Angel to Mary and said, "Hey, you're going to have a baby." And then the angel went to Joseph and said, "You know all that stuff Mary told you about the baby? It's entirely true."
Wow, that is quite a story.
Tell me about it. I was so stunned I did a spit take.
Really?
Yeah, it was kind of embarrassing. Water shot out of my mouth.
Wow, that's crazy. But did you really believe that he was a gift from God when you heard about the angels?
Well, I was a little skeptical at first. Most times you hear guys say they've seen angels, it turned out to be a little nuts. Well, then these shepherds come, and then some wise men.
You mean wise men?
Look, I don't know how wise they were. They brought like golden spices to a newborn baby. You know what a newborn baby really needs? Diapers.
Very true, but you saw all of these things.
I did, and when I saw them, I believed this was no ordinary baby. He was special, and he had the cutest little dimple.
All right, thanks for sharing your story, Doug. We'll be right back after the word.
Did you ever wonder, ever sit and wonder why people watch cheesy talk shows? Why does mom love to sit and listen to people babble on and on about their kids, their career, and the next movie? And how in the world can dad sit and listen to those guys talk for hours and hours about sports? They do it for the same reason people read books. They watch talk shows for the same reason we watch movies. Everybody loves a good story. Christmas is a great time for stories. There's the one about Buddy the Elf, and the one about the kid with the BB gun. And then there's the one about a man, a woman, and an angel.
This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, happened. His mother Mary was engaged to marry Joseph, but before they married, he learned that she was expecting a baby. Mary's husband, Joseph, was a good man. He did not want to cause her public disgrace, so he planned to break the engagement secret. But after Joseph thought about this, an angel from the Lord came to him in a dream. The angel said, "Joseph, son of David, don't be afraid to accept Mary to be your wife. The baby inside her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son. You will name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this happened to fulfill the meaning of what the Lord said through the prophet. "The virgin will conceive a child and give birth to a son. They will name him Emmanuel, which means God with us." When Joseph woke up, he did as the angels of the Lord told him to do.
Joseph and Mary were looking forward to their wedding. They thought they knew how their story was going. God put a twist into their tale and changed their lives for good. The twist that changed their tale changed our whole world.
Joins us now live. Please help me welcome Clara the cow.
Thanks for having me, Cindy.
It's Lindy.
It is?
Clara, I understand that you live in the stable where the baby Jesus was born.
Oh, what a little angel face. He was so cute. He had the sweetest giggle and that dimple. Oh, that dimple was adorable.
You remember the baby being born? Huh?
I'll never forget it.
You must have been thrilled to see him.
Absolutely not.
What?
I was not at all thrilled to have a bunch of people in my house at night.
Oh, come on. But it was
all day long. Greg the cook kept saying, "The inn is filling up. They're running out of room." And I kept saying, "No way they're going to send people out here. The stables are for animals, not people." But what do you think happens around bedtime?
Stable?
A man, a donkey, and a pregnant woman who immediately goes into labor.
She went to labor right away?
As ready as she was, she made it to Bethlehem.
Oh, okay. But she had the baby in the stable?
Oh, yes. And it was very difficult to sleep when someone was trying to give birth.
I guess so.
A cow has to have her sleep, Cindy.
It's Lindy.
You can't sleep when someone's trying to birth a baby. I see your point. Oh, but when the baby was born, I just knew he was special.
You knew right away?
Well, the star and the shepherd kind of clued me in, but yes. The whole stable just felt different because of his presence.
I guess that made everything okay, huh?
Well, almost. I was still mad at the innkeeper.
What for?
You don't put a baby in the stables, especially if that baby's the son of God.
Good point.
So, the innkeeper didn't get mugged for a few days.
Uh-oh.
Yes, and boy were his customers mad when they didn't have milk with their frosted flakes.
Frosted flakes? Who ever heard of frosted flakes in ancient Bethlehem?
Well, who ever heard of a talking cow?
Good point. Anyway, we've been talking with Claire the Cow, resident of Bethlehem, about her memories of the baby Jesus.
Oh, that's simple.
And we'll be right back with another amazing animal Christmas memory.
Wrapped him in cloths and laid him in the manger because there were no one left.
Imagine the creator of the universe, the Son of God who reigns in heaven, sleeping on a bed of hay. That's how Jesus entered the world, not as a conquering hero, but as the poor son of a carpenter. What an extraordinary beginning to a world-changing story.
Praising God and telling all of us about the baby.
Amazing.
You know, Mindy, it would seem kind of odd to me why the good Lord would invite a bunch of smelly shepherds to see his newborn son. Then I think God was just being neighborly. He sent Jesus for everybody, so he wanted to make sure everybody knew they was welcome to eat of smelly shepherds.
A beautiful message to end this interview.
And a smelly one, too. I mean it, Mindy. Them boys never bathe.
Thanks for joining us, Sammy. We'll see you next time on Lindy Lou Live.
Me?
No, the kids.
Oh, I got it. Adios, Buckaroo.
The people of Israel had waited for centuries for the birth of the Messiah. God told the story of his coming over and over through the prophets. But when the baby Jesus was born, he shared the story with a few lowly shepherds.
That night, some shepherds were out in the fields near Bethlehem watching their sheep. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord was shining around them. The shepherds were very afraid. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I have some very good news for you, news that will make everyone happy. Today your Messiah, the Lord, has been born in the town of David. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This is how you will know him. You will find a baby wrapped in pieces of cloth and lying in a manger." Then a huge army of angels from heaven joined the first angel, and they're all praising God, saying, "Praise God in heaven and on earth. Let there be peace to the people who please him." The angels left the shepherds and went back to the heaven. The shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this great event the Lord has told us about." So the shepherds went quickly and saw Mary and Joseph, and there was a baby lying in the manger. When they saw the baby, they told what the angels said about this child. Everyone was amazed when they heard what the shepherds told them. Mary held it into their heart and continued to think about them. The shepherds went back to their sheep, praising God and thanking them for everything they had seen and heard. It was just as the angels had told them.
God told the shepherds that Jesus had been born. And when he did, he told the world that Jesus had come for all of us. Jesus would not live in a palace separated from the world. Jesus wanted everyone to come to him, unafraid, so that he might be their savior. This message was not just for the rich and famous. This message was for the whole world.
Oh no.
Welcome back to Lindy Lou Live. We're wrapping up our special today on the story of Christmas. My final guest today traveled a very long way to see the baby Jesus. But I think we can all agree that was a wise decision. Please help me welcome Cody the Camel.
Thank you, Lindy. It's a pleasure.
You know my name?
Of course I do, Lindy Lou. You're a fine talk show host, and I love your work.
Do you know, you're the only animal who got my name right.
Well, you pick up a few things hanging out with the wise men.
I guess so.
That's how I came to meet baby Jesus, you know. My master and a few colleagues spotted a star in the sky, and we all set off on a long journey west.
Did you know you're going to see someone special?
We most certainly did. They don't call them wise men just for being good monopoly players, you know?
I guess not.
My master and his fellows had read the prophecies of the ancient Israelites telling of the way of the time and the way in which the new king would be born. As soon as they saw the star, they knew they had to look for themselves.
And the star led you to Bethlehem.
No, dear girl. It led us to Jerusalem. That's where the king is, you know. And he was quite puzzled when we asked about the newborn king. Thankfully, the king had some fairly wise fellows of his own, and they opened the book of Micah to say you will find him in Bethlehem.
How wise of you to ask directions.
Well, being wise doesn't mean you have all the answers, but it means being smart enough to ask directions.
Good. So you go to Jerusalem, and you see the baby Jesus.
A little pumpkin head. He was so cute.
That's what I hear.
He had the cutest dimple.
You know what? I've heard that, too.
My master and his associates brought gifts for him. They brought gold, a spice called frankincense, and gold called myrrh. These were gifts fit for a king, so it was rather strange seeing them in the hands of such poor parents. I could tell they had never seen such things in their lives.
They must have been overwhelmed.
They were, but not near as much to my master. You see, the gifts were nothing compared to the boy. He was the son of God. He was the redeemer of the world. He would bring something far more valuable than gold, frankincense, or myrrh. He would bring eternal life.
How true.
I still get people today asking me about our journey. What did the star look like? How much gold did we bring? How long did it take to get there? I tell them none of that really matters. We are not the story. The baby in the manger is the real story of Christmas.
Wise words from wise camel.
Thank you,
Cody.
Thank you, Lindy.
And that's it. This has been Lindy Lou Live, and now you know the story of the animals and the nativity. So long!
Christmas is a time of giving. It's a time for pitching money into the Salvation Army buckets and shopping for paper angels picked from a tree in the mall. I know you've all been shopping for weeks, looking for the perfect gift to give to special people in your life. You want to let them know with that gift just how special they are, just as the wise men did for Jesus. Just don't lose sight of the baby, who is the greatest gift of Christmas.
Jesus was born in the town of Bethlehem in Judea. During the time when Herod was king, after Jesus was born, some wise men from the east came to Jerusalem. They asked people, "Where is the child who has been born to the king of the Jews? We saw the star that shone he was born. We saw it rise in the sky to the east and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard about this, it upset him, as well as everyone else in Jerusalem. Herod called a meeting of all the leading Jewish priests and teachers of the law. He asked them, "Where is the Messiah? Where the Messiah would be born?" They answered, "In the town of Bethlehem, Judea, just as the prophet wrote, 'You, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, you are important among the rulers of Judea. A ruler will come from you and lead Israel. That ruler will be like a shepherd for my people.'" When Herod had a private meeting with the wise men from the east, he learned from them the exact time they first saw the star. Then he sent them to Bethlehem. He said, "Go and look carefully for the child. When you find
worship him too. After the wise men heard the king, they left. They saw the star they had seen in the east, and they followed it. The star went before them until it stopped above the place where the child was. Then they were happy and excited to see the star. The wise men came to the house where the child was with his mother Mary. They bowed down to worship him. Then they opened the boxes and gifts they had brought for him. They gave him treasures of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. But God warned the wise men in a dream not to go back to Herod. So they went home to their own country a different way.
Try all you want. You'll never top the gift that God gave us. Even the wise men with the gold, frankincense, and myrrh couldn't match it. God gave us Jesus. He gave us a Savior who would die for our sins and offer us eternal life. You can look at every store, you can browse every website, but you'll never find a gift as wonderful as Jesus. Yourself in the Christmas lights, or will you begin a new tale by receiving the greatest gift ever given? He's waiting for your answer.
Lord is come, let her be seen, her King.
coming. Parents, grandparents, aunts and uncles, brothers and sisters, and even those who just came to come. Thank you to everyone who helped make tonight possible. Merry Christmas and good night.
Merry Christmas!